The closest star outside of our solar system is 4.2 light years away. That means it takes 4.2 years for light to travel from that star to us, pretty far away. But you might wonder, how do astronomers have any idea how far away stars are? It's a great question. And there's actually lots of techniques astronomers use to figure this out. But one very important tool is the brightness of a star. You see, as we get farther away from a light source, things get less bright. If you're right nearby a lamp, it's pretty bright. And as you're far, it gets less and less bright. And we actually have a mathematical equation that describes that change in brightness and how it depends on distance. So if we can estimate how bright the star actually is and compare that to how bright it appears, we can figure out how far away it is. Let's learn to think carefully about brightness in this lesson. Let's review our lesson objectives. First, we'll examine why lights grow less bright. Then we'll introduce the equation for brightness. And lastly, we'll use the brightness equation. Here is a light bulb of a lighthouse. It's really bright. It's meant so that ships, even at a great distance, can see the light. As we get farther away, though, it does get less bright. And we're familiar with this observation. Distant lights are less bright. Here's the thing though, the light didn't go anywhere. That light bulb is still emitting all the same amount of light and none of it disappeared as it traveled to you. So why is it less bright? Well, to understand this question, we need to think carefully about a sphere. That's right, a sphere. Specifically, we're going to think about the surface area of the sphere. That's the area of the surface on our sphere. And we can calculate that with this equation. A stands for area, and it's going to be in meters squared for our purposes. We plug in the radius of our sphere, which is just halfway the distance through the middle of that sphere, and we'll use meters, and then we multiply by pi, which is a Greek letter that represents 3.14, which you've probably used in other classes. We'll multiply that by 4, and we get the surface area. Let's imagine now that you put a light bulb at the center of the sphere. Okay, well, as that light comes out of the light bulb, at any given distance from it, we can imagine a sphere going around it, and the light that came out of the light bulb at the beginning is going to be smeared out across the surface of that sphere. So the light is smeared out on the surface of a sphere. Here's a light bulb with a relatively short radius or a short distance to the edge of our sphere. What happens as we make the sphere bigger? Well, that's going to increase the surface area of the sphere. So as we get farther and farther away, the same quantity of light has to be smeared out over a greater distance. So at greater distances, the light is more smeared out. And that's really at the heart of why lights get less bright. Here, we can think about this situation a little more carefully by showing three segments of a sphere around a source of electromagnetic radiation, basically just a light bulb. We have one square at a distance r. At twice that distance, notice we have four squares. And at three times that distance, notice we have nine squares. So the surface area of our sphere is growing as we go farther and farther away from our light. And the same amount of light is still ultimately having to go through all of those different surfaces. So notice at a distance r, there's many more of those red arrows per square. Those red arrows here represent light. And so as we get farther and farther away, there is less and less light per square meter, which is in fact exactly what we call brightness. So brightness is the quantity of light per meter squared. Let's introduce the equation for brightness now. Here we have B equals P over 4 pi r squared. Some of that should look familiar. The P stands for the power of light source. So that's just how much power our light bulb is putting out. And we're going to measure that in watts. What does this bottom thing represent? Well, that's the surface area of a sphere, and hopefully you can understand why it's there, because we're taking the power of our light source and we're just dividing it by the surface area at a given distance. And that's what R represents here, the distance to the light. B then is brightness. Okay, let's think about the units for brightness. P, we said, was in watts, and we know that our denominator, 4 pi r squared, is going to be in meters squared. That means brightness will be measured in watts per meter squared. And that's where we get this sort of funny sounding definition, the quantity of light per meter squared. So we're just thinking about how much light is there per area. Okay, let's put this equation into use. This problem says a candle with a power of 85 watts has a brightness of 3.0 watts per meter squared at a certain distance. How far is the observer from the candle? So we're trying to figure out how far away we are from the candle by how bright it is. This is actually analogous to how scientists, specifically astronomers, use the brightness of stars to figure out how far away they are. Let's start by writing down the variables we've been given. We've been given the power of our candle, and we're told that it is 85 watts. I think that's a pretty powerful candle. Then we're told the brightness of the candle. We know that at some particular distance, it's going to be 3.0 watts per meter squared. And we're told to find the distance. In this case, that is going to be represented by the variable r. Here's the challenge. We know that if we look at our equation, it isn't solved for r. So actually, before we even plug in any numbers, let's rearrange this equation for r. This can be a little tricky. R is on the bottom. And when r is on the bottom, the first thing we want to do is get it off of the bottom of our fraction there. So how are we going to do that? We're just going to multiply by r squared. So remember, whenever you are trying to figure out an algebra equation for the number that's on the bottom, we always need to start by getting it off the bottom. And now our r squareds there are going to cancel out, and we'll get r squared b equals p over 4 pi. Okay, now we want to continue to try to get r by itself. Notice it's a little easier now that r squared is up top. We're going to divide both sides by b. And what that does is that gets rid of b over on the left-hand side, and we get r squared equals power divided by 4 pi times b. Okay, last step here, we need to get rid of that squared, so we're going to take the square root of both sides. When we take the square root of both sides, we'll get just regular old r equals the square root of p divided by 4 pi b. Okay, now let's plug in the numbers we've been given. R is equal to the square root of our power, which is 85, divided by 4 times pi times the brightness, which we know is 3.0. So what I want you to do now is grab your calculator. Go on, grab it. You can pause the video. And then in your calculator, do 85 divided by 4 pi times 3. It may be a good idea, once again, to put this in parentheses. Whenever you're dividing some complicated number, putting the bottom in parentheses is always a good idea. Then we're going to take the square root of that number. When you do that, you should get 1.501. When we round for two sig figs, because both of our variables given have two sig figs, we get 1.5 meters. So that's how far we must be from the candle. Now it's your turn to practice. What is the brightness of a 50 watt light bulb at a distance of 10 meters? Pause the video and give this a try. You should have gotten that the brightness was 0.0398 watts per meter squared. If you were unable to get that answer, pause the video and see where you went wrong in your steps. Let's review what we've learned. First, we examined why lights grow less bright. Namely, that as we get farther from a light, the light coming out of that source is smeared across a sphere of a greater and greater size. So there's just less light per area. Then we introduced the equation for brightness, where we saw the surface area of the sphere played a really important role. Then we used the brightness equation to see how the brightness of lights varies with distance. Hey, hey.